I had a learner that I used to work with in a residential setting. This is probably 9 years ago. Really cool kid. It took quite a bit of time for him to decrease his physical aggression. So he basically would just come up to people, and instead of shaking your hand, he would just do a wind up and just like clock on the top of your head. So that's how he would greet you. So I worked with him in a residential setting, and every time I'd walk in, it was just a wind up and boom, I'd go to high five him and he would just smack me over the head. So what I realized is that when I did a functional behavior assessment, I identified that there was a dual function. He was doing it for a reaction, but more importantly, the main function was for an automatic or sensory reinforcement. Because what was occurring was every time he would wind up and hit you over the head, his behavior plan said that you had to do a physical restraint. You were supposed to put him in a standing basket hold and hold his arms to his chest for, it was like a 2 minute basket hold. So it was interesting because he used to say all the time, he'd be like, "Mr. Brett," he goes, "I'm just doing it for attention and I like when people hold me." And so he basically would tell you the reason he's doing it and nobody listened to him. So I actually listened to him and realized that, okay, if he's doing it for some sensory feeling to be held and for attention, then why don't we just flip it around? So I started teaching him, let's call him Bobby. So I'd say, "All right, Bobby, so instead of hitting me," I would actually redirect him. I'd come up, enter the residence, and before he had a behavior problem, I would make it successful by whipping around, and I'd say, "Bobby, repeat me, pressure please." And he would say, "Pressure please, Mr. Brett." And I would actually go around and I would hold him and squeeze him. And I would kind of, it was like a bear hug, and he would smile and he had this look on his face. So I would also provide some praise right after he said it. So regularly, routinely, every time I go in the residence, before he would swing at me, I'd say, "Bobby, what do we do?" And he would say, "Oh, Mr. Brett, pressure please." And then he would turn around and I would just give him a little squeeze for literally 5 seconds and he would smile, and that was the functional equivalent. So he learned the alternative behavior. Instead of taking all the effort to go hit you on the head, all he had to do was vocalize, "Pressure please." And those two words was a lot less effort than hitting you over the head. And then from there on out, it would generalize. He would just go up to people and instead of hitting them, he'd say, "Pressure please." And the functional equivalent response that fulfilled the same sensory need was just a little squeeze, a little hug. So the cool thing was that 5 years later, I got asked to his parents called me and said he was in a different residential facility now, and that what he's doing is going around very aggressively and hitting people over the head. So I'm thinking, all right, maybe the functions haven't changed. So the reason why I knew behavioral science was so powerful is that 5 years later, I go to the residential program and I enter, and Bobby, after not seeing me for 5 years, walks up. It's me, Marlene, and three residential staff. I was the last one to enter the residence. He sees Marlene, doesn't know her, it's my fiance, and just tries to clock her over the head. Marlene blocks it. It's not even that much effort. He just winds up and goes like this. The other three residential staff, he looked at them, swung one over the head, they blocked. Third staff, swung over the hand. And then he sees me, and he says, "Mr. Brett, pressure please." So after 5 years, he remembered just the simple request to mand for sensory reinforcement and for me to give him a little bit of attention. And right away he turned around for the hug and he didn't hit me. So what was really cool was that 5 years went by and many behavior plans came and went, but the fact that his parents retained me to go up there years later and the appropriate behavior still was emitted, it was awesome. And it was pretty cool because the residential staff began just strengthening his appropriate request for squeeze and attention. So it was just the proof that behavioral science can go for, you know, half a decade and still work.